friends, today in this video I will be discuss firstly some more important methods of the preparation of phenol, that meaning some important methods of preparation of phenol. Some important methods of preparation of phenol. Under this, the first point that I have taken, this is from benzene sulfonic acid. The benzene sulfonic acid. Now I will be show you here ki how to make the benzene sulfonic acid also. If we want to make the benzene sulfonic acid, then benzene reacted with oleum, or I can say that this is a fuming H2SO4. The formula of that oleum is H2S2O7, or you want to make it, then H2SO4 plus SO3, this is the oleum, or I can say that fuming H2SO4. When benzene reacted with oleum, then it will be give us benzene sulfonic acid. This is SO3H, benzene sulfonic acid. Now this benzene sulfonic acid reacted with NaOH. From here H and from here OH react to release out H2O, and here we are getting SO3Na. This is sodium benzene sulfonate. Now this sodium benzene sulfonate again reacted with two molecules of NaOH. Suppose this is the one molecule of NaOH and this is the second molecule of NaOH. Now this will be react from here. This is Na2SO3 will be remove out from here. This is Na2SO3, and from here this is OH, and this H in the form of water molecule it is released out. The rest of ONA will be attached with the benzene ring. This is ONA. This is sodium phenoxide. This sodium phenoxide in acidic medium, that is reacted with an acid. If I will be say ki that is a reacted with HCl, then from here Na and Cl react to release out NaCl, and we are getting here phenol. This is OH, that is phenol. This is benzene. This is benzene sulfonic acid. So this is the first method of the preparation of phenol from benzene sulfonic acid. Now after this I will be discuss the second method, that is from diazonium salt. This is very important method, the diazonium salt. How to make the diazonium salt, already I have teach you in haloalkene and haloarene chapter, but again I will be show you here. When aniline reacted with HNO2, that meaning HNO2 nitrous acid, aniline, the formula of aniline you know, this is NH2. This is aniline. It reacted with HNO2. This HNO2 you can write in this way also, NaNO2 plus HCl at the temperature of 0 to 5 degree Celsius. 0 to 5 degree Celsius, then we are getting benzene diazonium chloride. This is N2Cl. This is the benzene diazonium chloride. Now, this benzene diazonium chloride reacted with hot water, or you can say that warm H2O. Then, this N2 release as it is, H2O we know, it will be converted, split up into HN and OHN. HN reacted with Cl to release out HCl, and OH will be attached with the benzene ring. This is, that meaning we are getting phenol, N2, and that is HCl. Or you can say that here only this, ki from here N2 is released out, and from here HCl is released out, and we are getting here phenol. Now, after this, the third method that I am going to discuss with you, this is with a Grignard reagent. With Grignard reagent, that is Grignard reagent. Third method is here by Grignard reagent. This is also the important one. Grignard reagent, this is the alkyl magnesium halide. As we know that Grignard reagent meaning RMGX, this is alkyl magnesium halide. We need a benzene, that meaning I need a phenol, that meaning phenol meaning C6H5OH, or I can say that this is the phenol OH. So in the Grignard reagent, this alkyl part I need this one, that meaning the phenyl one. So I will be take here aryl magnesium halide, that meaning here I will be use here aryl magnesium halide. So this is magnesium halide, aryl magnesium halide. This aryl magnesium halide reacted with oxygen. That meaning this oxygen will be getting from atmosphere O2. This is the half O2, it will be there. This half O2 meaning oxygen atom is one. This oxygen atom is attached here and it will be giving us OMGX. This is OMGX. Now, it's very simple now. This OMGX, this is phenyl oxymagnesium bromide. Phenyl oxy magnesium halide. If I will take it a Br, so this will be the bromide. This will be reacted with warm water. Warm water. Then again H2O, that we know that it will be split up into H positive and OH negative. So this OH negative reacted with MgX, it will be giving us this MgOHX will be released out, and H will be reacted with O and it will be giving us phenol. This is OH, this is the phenol. I hope you have understood all the three methods, and these are also the important three methods to make the phenol. Lots of time they are asking in the form of conversion. That is why I have discussed here. If you want to take in place of X any halogen, you can take it Br. Same you can take it here Br. So here also Br will come. So this will be on that time. This is bromide. So that is the main methods of the preparation of phenol. In my next video, I will be discuss the chemical properties of phenol because physical properties already I have discussed in my previous video. So now I will be discuss after this video that is the chemical properties of phenol. Thank you. Morning student. Today in this video I will be discuss the chemical properties of phenol. The chemical properties of phenol, so firstly I will be discuss the acidic character of phenol. This is very important. Acidic character of phenol. We can explain the acidic character of phenol very easily. Firstly though, I will be discussing very simply why the phenol is behaving as an acid. Because phenol react with the metal to release out hydrogen gas. So that meaning that is behave as acid. Like suppose I have a phenol that is two molecules of this phenol. I can write the phenol in this way also. It's two molecules I have taken. This is reacted with sodium. So what the sodium will do? This is a metal. So sodium will be displaced the hydrogen from here and it will be giving us sodium phenoxide. This is O Na. This is the two molecule of this and release out hydrogen gas. So we know that the any substance that will be released hydrogen gas when reacted with the metal, that will be the acid. So simply here phenol also react with sodium, that is a metal, to give us the sodium phenoxide and release the hydrogen gas. So we can say that this is a acid. But we can explain it with the other methods also. If you will see in the phenol, then hydroxyl group in phenol is directly attached to the sp2 hybridized carbon. If you will see in the phenol, this is the phenol, this is the hydroxyl group, and this hydroxyl group is attached with this carbon. Here carbon is present and the double bond is present. That meaning this is sp2 hybridized carbon. So due to this sp2 hybridized carbon, this is act as electron withdrawing group. That meaning that total this part is a phenyl group which is a electron withdrawing group. Due to this electron withdrawing group, the electron density is going to decrease. That meaning due to this electron withdrawing group, the electron is transferred towards the oxygen. So electron density is going to decrease on oxygen. So therefore hydrogen ion is easily removed from here. So we can say that phenol is behave as an acid. Now if you will be see if any electron withdrawing group will be there, any electron withdrawing group is available there, then the acidic character is going to increase. Acidic character increase meaning the electron density on this oxygen decrease. Due to decrease in the electron density, that will be hydrogen will be released easily from here. So this will behave as an acidic character. If any electron releasing group will be available here, this is the electron releasing group, then the acidic character decrease. Why this is decrease? Because if any electron releasing group will be available here, then the electron density on this oxygen is going to increase. So it will be hold this hydrogen more tightly. It will be not lose the hydrogen easily. Therefore the acidic character decrease. So from here though, we can easily understand ki phenol is acidic in nature. Now we will compare the acidic character of phenol and alcohol. That also I will be explaining here only with the same thing. If you will see in the phenol, The same thing is available here. Electron withdrawing group is present. That is a phenyl group. This is phenyl group. This is electron withdrawing group. Whereas in alcohol, alkyl group is there. This is the alkyl group. That is electron releasing group. Electron releasing group. So that meaning in a phenol, due to the presence of this electron withdrawing group, the electron density near the oxygen decrease, so it will be easily release the hydrogen ion. Whereas in alcohol, alkyl group is present, which is electron releasing group, so that is why the electron density on this oxygen increase, so it will be hold the hydrogen more tightly, it will not release it easily. So that meaning this is less acidic than phenol. So we can say that phenol is more acidic. Phenol is more acidic than alcohol. Phenol is more acidic than alcohol. Now, that we can explain it with the help of resonance structure also. The resonance structure already I have discussed with you people in my previous video. Now, I will be discuss the chemical properties of phenol, that will be the electrophilic substitution reaction that is given by the phenol. Electrophilic substitution reaction given by the phenol. Electrophilic substitution reaction given by the phenol. Electrophilic, this is electrophilic substitution reaction given by phenol. Now, first of all, I will be discuss here, if any electrophile will be available, so on which position it will be going to attack, that we can discuss only with the help of resonance structure. That resonance structure of phenol, if I will be see, so this will be in this way. This is OH. Two lone pair is available here. So the bond will be pi electron. The bond which are present in this pi electron, it will be coming here, and this will be coming on this place. So this will be giving us the double bond available here. Oxygen has giving its electron. So that is why this is a positively charged, and the pi electron pair will be coming here. Now this pi electron pair will be transferred on this benzene ring. How it will be? That double bond will be coming here. This pi electron will be coming on this position. So this will be available. Double bond O. This is a positively charged. This is a double bond because pi electron is coming here. And this will be the electron pair will be transferring here. Now, this electron pair will be transferred here, so this bond will be give the electron on this position. So, this will be giving double bond O, single bond H. This is positive. Electron pair available here, double bond, this is. Now, this will be transferring here, and this bond will be giving on the back to the oxygen. So we are getting here single bond, or due to the transferring of electron, positive charge will be removed from here. This is H. This is the double bond. This is. So this is the first structure, second, third, fourth, and fifth. So these are the resonance structure of phenol. Here you will be seeing the transferring of electron only on ortho and para position. This is the ortho, this is the para, and this is also the ortho. That meaning ki whenever any electrophile will be attacked, so that will be attacked only on ortho and para. para position on the phenol. Now I will be discuss the first property, that is the nitration. This is nitration. First property, this is nitration. In nitration, that meaning phenol is reacted with HNO3. Now phenol will be react in two ways. Firstly, it can react with dilute HNO3, or in second it react with concentrated HNO3. If first case means case first I will be take here, this is with dilute HNO3. Now this is the phenol, this is, it reacted with HNO3, this is dilute. Whenever phenol reacted with dilute HNO3, then it will be giving us ortho nitrophenol and para nitrophenol. That will be in the presence of H2SO4. So as we know that key hydroxy group is ortho and para directing group. So nitro group will be attached on ortho and para position. This is the ortho and this is the para. This is ortho nitrophenol and this is para nitrophenol. Now the two things are available here, ki ortho nitrophenol and para nitrophenol. This is a mixture. How to separate out this mixture? That we can separate out with the help of steam distillation. That meaning if I want to separate both of them, separation, I want to do the separation, then I will do with the help of steam distillation. Steam distillation, that is also very important. Ki how the steam distillation we will follow here. Now in a ortho nitrophenol, the intramolecular hydrogen bonding is present. Due to the presence of intramolecular hydrogen bonding, this is steam volatile. This is steam volatile. Whereas in a para nitrophenol, that is intermolecular hydrogen bonding, which is less volatile. So that is why with the help of steam distillation we can separate out. Now I will be show here ki how they will form the intramolecular hydrogen bonding or intermolecular hydrogen bonding. If I will be discuss here the intramolecular hydrogen bonding, so that will be, suppose I have the ortho nitrophenol, this is the ortho nitrophenol, this is OH, and here nitro group is available, this nitrogen with double bond oxygen and coordinate covalent bond oxygen. So this is a oxygen is a more electronegative, and this is a hydrogen. So they are going to form the hydrogen bonding. This hydrogen bonding is formed in the same molecule, the hydrogen and oxygen of the same molecule. That is why this is a intramolecular hydrogen bonding. This is a steam volatile. Steam volatile, or you can say that this is a more volatile. This is more volatile compound. And in a para, this will be coming in this way. This is the phenol, and para, this is a nitrogen. Now this is the coordinate covalent bond, this is a double bond oxygen. This is a one molecule. Same we will take the other molecule. The other molecule, if I will be take the same way, this is OH, same. This is nitrogen, double bond with oxygen and coordinate covalent bond. So two different molecules are available here, and the hydrogen of one molecule and the oxygen of other molecule, they are going to form the hydrogen bonding. So this is the intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Intermolecular hydrogen bonding, which is less volatile. less volatile. That is why with the help of steam distillation we can separate it. Now that is the case first with dilute HNO3. Now case second, that is with concentrated HNO3. Concentrated HNO3. Case second, this is with concentrated HNO3. Now with concentrated HNO3, what will be happen? This will be the phenol, and very important product we are getting from here. This is the phenol, concentrated HNO3. I will be use it here. This should be the concentrated in the presence of acidic medium. I will be getting here the product. This is, that means the nitro group will be attached on ortho and para position. This is the phenol. This is ortho. This is para. If I will coming from that side, then this is ortho. That meaning 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a 2, 4, 6. So that means the compound is 2, 4, 6. Trinitrophenol. It's a common name that is very important. This is a picric acid. This is picric acid. That meaning phenol to picric acid. Lots of time they are asking in conversion. That meaning phenol to picric acid. One thing keep in your mind. The same case first, case second. Case first, that was with dilute HNO3. Mono compound we are getting. This is the case second with concentrated HNO3. We are getting the picric acid. Now the next part that I will be discuss with you in my next video. Thank you. Students, in this video I will be discuss the halogenation of phenol and some more chemical properties of phenol. So first of all I will be go with the halogenation of phenol. Here also two cases are there for the halogenation of phenol. Case first, if I will be see, so here ki any halogen, suppose I have taken here bromine. Bromine will be reacted with phenol in the low polarity of solvent. That meaning in the presence of low polarity of solvent, like this low polarity of solvent, like this is the chloroform, that is CHCl3 or CS2 carbon disulfide, then they will be giving us the mono halobenzene. Now like suppose I have a phenol, this is the OH, this is, now it is going to react with Br2 in the presence of CS2 or CHCl3, then what will be happen here? Br one is giving us the ortho, simply we knows that ki OH group is available here, so this is the ortho and para directing group, so Br will be attached on ortho position or Br will be attached on para position. This is OH and this is Br, that meaning this is ortho bromo phenol, ortho bromo phenol and para bromo phenol. That is, keep in your mind, if that will be the low polarity of solvent is available here, then they will giving us the ortho and para bromo. The case second is available here. Suppose I will be use the case second, then case second is there, that will be with bromine water. With bromine water, if I will be use here bromine water, then it will be giving us suppose this is the phenol, this is OH, it is reacted with bromine water, then this is the water, bromine water, then they will be giving us that is OH, this is the Br, this is the Br, this is the Br. That meaning 2,4,6 tribromo phenol. This is the white PPT. White PPT, that meaning Br is attached on the ortho and para position, and the 3 Br that will be react with H to release out 3 HBr from here. So that meaning phenol to 2,4,6 tribromo phenol, that is a white PPT. That are the two cases mostly you have seen. The halogenation reaction take place in the presence of Lewis acid like AlCl3, FeCl3. But in this reaction there is no need of any Lewis acid because OH group is highly activating group. This OH group that is lying here, this is a very highly activating group. Due to that this group itself polarize the Br2 to give electrophile. That is why there is no need to use any Lewis acid, or we can say that in this reaction there is no use of Lewis acid, because mostly in electrophilic reaction the Lewis acid is needed, but here there is no need. So that you keep in your mind ki why there is no need of Lewis acid, because OH is a highly polarized. So that is why it will be, due to the highly polarized, it will be itself polarize the Br2 group, or we can say that this is a highly activating group. Due to the highly activating group, it will be polarize itself the bromine as a electrophile. Now I will be go with the second property. This is the reaction with zinc metal. Reaction with zinc metal. This is very simple reaction with zinc metal. I can say that this is the reduction of phenol. Reduction of phenol. When phenol reacted with zinc metal, this is the phenol reacted with zinc metal, then this will be Zn reacted with oxygen, release out zinc oxide, and that will be giving us benzene. This is benzene and zinc oxide is released out. That meaning that in conversion, this is very important. This is phenol to benzene we can get. The third is oxidation of phenol. Oxidation of phenol. If I will be discuss here in oxidation of phenol, so in the presence of chromic acid, chromic acid that is going to oxidize, and it will be giving us the diketone. Like suppose I am having, this is the phenol, this is, it is going to oxidize in the presence of CrO3, then it will be giving us a product of diketone. This is the benzoquinone. Benzoquinone, that meaning phenol to benzoquinone. Now the rest of some more important reactions of phenol is there, that I will be discuss with you people in my next video. Thank you. Morning students, today in this video I will be discuss some special reactions of phenol. Like first is Kolbe reaction. In this reaction, sodium phenoxide react with carbon dioxide. This is sodium phenoxide. It react with carbon dioxide, 400 Kelvin and 4 to 7 atmospheric pressure. when sodium phenoxide reacted with carbon dioxide at a 400 Kelvin 4 to 7 atmospheric pressure, then it will be giving this CO2 is attached here. It is giving OCOONA. That means this is a CO2 is attached here. Now we after the rearrangement, that meaing it is going to rearrange. This is rearrangement. This is give us this is O Na as it is. The hydrogen I can write in this way of that benzene ring. This hydrogen and this C double O, they are combined to give us C double OH. Now this is during the acidification. This is acidification, that meaning it reacted with HCl, then this Cl react with Na to release out NaCl, and H will be comes on this place, and we are getting here OHCOOH. This is salicylic acid. Salicylic acid. Now the other name of this compound is 1,2. This is a 2-hydroxy, and this is a salicylic, sorry, benzoic acid. 2-hydroxy benzoic acid. This is the other name of this compound. That meaning in Kolbe reaction, sodium phenoxide reacted with carbon dioxide at 400 Kelvin and 4 to 7 atmospheric pressure give us this compound, that during the rearrangement this will be coming in ONA and CWH is available here. After that, by the acidification reacted with dilute HCl, NaCl will be released out, and we are getting here a main compound, that is a salicylic acid, or I can say that 2-hydroxybenzoic acid, that is sodium phenoxide. Now the point is available here ki how to get this sodium phenoxide. This sodium phenoxide easily we can get it when phenol, this is the phenol, react with NaOH, then this OH and H react to release out H2O, and we are getting here sodium phenoxide. So in mostly in exam they are asking the conversion ki how we will make the salicylic acid from phenol. So this is the way to make the salicylic acid, or we can say that this is our whole Kolbe reaction. That is very important reaction, lots of time they are asking in naming reaction. Now the second reaction is here, Riemann-Thiemann reaction. Riemann-Thiemann reaction, that is Riemann-Thiemann reaction. Riemann-Thiemann reaction, this is also naming reaction, that is also very important. Now how to go with this Riemann-Thiemann reaction? Now this is also starting from phenol. The phenol, this is phenol reacted with chloroform CHCl3 in the presence of NaOH. Now from here Na will be displaced the hydrogen, and it will be coming ONA. This is the ONA, and this Cl reacted with Na to release out NaCl and one molecule of water, that is H2O. This CHCl2 is left here, that CHCl2 will be attached on this position. Whatever hydrogen will be replaced by CHCl2 from here, that reacted with OH to release H2O. Now दिस CHCl2 अगेन रिएक्टेड विद टू मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ NaOH. द टू मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ NaOH आई एम टेकिंग बिकॉज टू एटम ऑफ Cl इज अवेलेबल हेयर. सो दिस टू एटम ऑफ Cl रिएक्टेड विद टू Na एटम टू रिलीज आउट फ्रॉम हेयर टू NaCl. And we are getting here the product. This is O Na single bond C single bond H. This two OH is available here. One OH I'm writing here. Second OH is writing here. This is the unstable compound. This is unstable compound. To make it stable, one water molecule is eliminated from here. How? This will be the water molecule eliminated from here. This is the water molecule eliminated from here, that meaning minus H2O. The left product is CHO, that meaning this is O Na and this is CHO. After this, the acidification reacted with acid HCl, Na reacted with Cl, release out NaCl, and H will be attached there. This is OH and CHO, that meaning this is salicylaldehyde. Salicylaldehyde. Now, the other name is, this is the 1 and 2, 2 hydroxy benzaldehyde. The other name is 2 hydroxy benzaldehyde. After this, we can say that this is phenol to salicylaldehyde. That meaning whenever phenol reacted with chloroform, then during this whole process, we are getting the salicylaldehyde, and this process is known as Reimer-Timmons reaction. This is a one way of the Reimer-Timmons reaction. In one more way, we can represent the Reimer-Timmons reaction. That is, I am discussing with you. If phenol, this is the phenol, in place of chloroform, reacted with carbon tetrachloride, reacted with CCl4 carbon tetrachloride, in the presence of NaOH, then from here, same I'm telling you, Na will be reacted, display this hydrogen, and they will be giving us ONa. This is ONa. One Na reacted with Cl, release out NaCl, and one water molecule will be released from here. This is, that means two I have taken here. So, two water molecules will be released out from here. Now, the rest of the product is here. This is CCl3, because one Cl reacted with Na to release out NaCl. So, this CCl3 will be attached here by replacing the hydrogen which reacted with OH to release out water molecule. Now, this will be react with three molecule of NaOH. I'm taking here three molecules of NaOH because three atom of chlorine is available here. This 3 atom of chlorine reacted with 3 Na atom to release out NaCl, that meaning 3 NaCl from here. This 3 NaCl, if that will be removed, so I am getting here the product. This is ONa, that is single bond C. 3 OH will be attached here. This is the 1 OH, 2nd OH, and this is the 3rd OH. This is also the unstable compound. This is unstable compound. So to make it stable, one more water molecule is eliminated from here like this. This is the water molecule eliminated from here. As the water molecule will be eliminated from here, we are getting the product. This is ONa and this is COOH. COOH. This again, during the acidification, reacted with HCl, Cl reacted with Na to release out NaCl, and H will be attached there. That meaning we are getting here salicylic acid. This is OH, this is COOH. This is the salicylic acid and this is the phenol. So this is also the other method to make salicylic acid from phenol. So that are the two ways to represent the Reimer-Tiemann reaction. Now I'm discussing the third naming reaction, that is a coupling reaction. That is a coupling reaction. Coupling reaction. This is a coupling reaction. Coupling reaction. In the coupling reaction, cold solution of benzene diazonium chloride react with a cold solution of phenol to give us a azo dye. That is known as a coupling reaction. Meaning, suppose I am having here benzene diazonium chloride. This is, I can write in this way. This is double bond NCl. This is a benzene diazonium chloride. Benzene diazonium chloride. Benzene diazonium chloride. Now, this benzene diazonium chloride reacted with phenol. I can write the phenol in this way. H of this carbon, I will attach it here, and this is the OH. I am taking the H of this benzene ring outside. So that meaning this Cl and H react to each other, release out HCl, and they will be giving us the main product in this way. That is, the rest of the part is attached as it is. This is N double bond N. This is the benzene ring. And here OH. This is a azo dye, which is orange in color. This is orange in color. And the name of this is para-hydroxy azobenzene. Para-hydroxy azobenzene. I hope you have understand all these three naming reactions that are very important. Lots of time they are asking in exam as a naming reaction or as a conversion. Now after this I will be discuss the chemical test. Some chemical test I will be discuss with you in my next video. Thank you. Good morning students. Today in this video I will be discuss about the distinction between primary, secondary and tertiary alcohol. Lots of time in exam they are asking the chemical test. They are giving you some two compounds and they are asking you what is the chemical test, how you can distinguish between them. So in this point, firstly I'm going to take the Lucas test. Yeah, Lucas reagent test. Lucas test. In Lucas test we are using Lucas reagent. Lucas reagent. Lucas reagent is a mixture of ZnCl2 and HCl. Already I have discussed this in the chemical properties, but again I am going to explain you. Suppose I am having a test tube A, test tube B, test tube C. This is a test tube A, test tube B, test tube C, and all these test tubes I am keeping some chemicals. That chemicals is belonging to alcohol. Like suppose in test tube C, tertiary alcohol is available here. In test tube B, this is the secondary alcohol. In test tube A, this is a primary alcohol. Suppose. But I don't know these things. Ki primary, secondary and tertiary alcohol are present in which test tube. Now, I am adding in all the test tubes Lucas reagent. Lucas reagent. In this also Lucas reagent. Lucas reagent. In this also the same thing I am going to add it. So, I am talking about primary, secondary and tertiary alcohol. The tertiary alcohol, if I will be added it in Lucas reagent, so it will be give us the turbidity. Turbidity immediately. That meaning at the same time it will be giving us the turbidity. Now this will be indicate the presence of tertiary alcohol if the turbidity will become immediately by adding the Lucas reagent. If turbidity will become turbidity will come after 5 minutes. Immediately it will be not come, but after 5 minutes it will become. Then this indicates that this is a secondary alcohol. And in primary alcohol there is no turbidity at room temperature. No turbidity at room temperature. No turbidity at room temperature. So in this way we can easily identify ki which one is the primary alcohol, which one is the secondary and which one is the tertiary alcohol. If the primary alcohol is available here, by adding Lucas reagent the turbidity will not come at room temperature. In secondary alcohol, if I will be add the Lucas reagent, then turbidity will come after 5 to 10 minutes. And in tertiary alcohol, if I will be add the Lucas reagent, then the turbidity will come immediately. So in this way also we can identify ki which one is the primary, which one is the secondary and which one is the tertiary alcohol. Now after this, the secondary test is that is very important test. This is a very important test. That I will be discuss. This is the iodoform test. Iodoform test. In the iodoform test, that is very simple. Ki which compound will give us the iodoform test? The alcohol which contain CH3 single bond, CH single bond, OH single bond. This group, the alcohol which contain this group, they will be give us positive iodoform test. Positive iodoform test. If this group is absent in any alcohol, then that will be not give us the positive iodoform test. That meaning that will be not give us the positive iodoform test, that will be give us the negative iodoform test. Like suppose I have two alcohol, one is a ethanol and one is a methanol. One is the ethanol, this is CH3CH2OH, and one is CH3OH. That meaning this is the ethanol and this is the methanol. Now how I can distinguish both of them are a primary alcohol? Now I want to distinguish between these two. How we can identify which one is the ethanol and which one is the methanol? I am going to draw their structure of ethanol and methanol. If you will see the structure of ethanol and methanol, the ethanol structure I can draw in this way. CH3 single bond C. H single bond means I can say that H here and OH here, and this is H. So this is CH3 CH2OH. So that meaning in ethanol you can see that group is present. So this will be giving us the positive iodoform test. Positive iodoform test. Whereas in methanol, if I will be see, this is CH3 single bond OH. That meaning this group is absent. So this will be not give iodoform test. Not give iodoform test. Now what is the iodoform test? That I want to discuss. In this test we have to heat the alcohol with aqueous NaOH or Na2CO3 and iodine solution. On warming the reaction mixture, yellow PPT of iodoform indicate the positive iodoform test. That meaning I will be take the mixture of sodium hydroxide and iodine. Suppose I have CH3CH2OH. I'm taking here the mixture of sodium hydroxide and iodine. This is 4I2 plus 6NaOH. When I will be heated on warming, this will be give us the iodoform. दिस इज सी एच आई थ्री, दिस इज द आयडोफोम, आयडोफोम विच इज अ येल्लो पीपीटी, येल्लो पीपीटी दैट विल बी सेटल डाउन एट द बॉटम एंड इट विल बी गिविंग अस द एच सी डबल ओ एन ए सोडियम फॉर्मेट प्लस 5 एन ए आई एंड विद द वॉटर मॉलिक्यूल दिस इज 5H2O, 5H2O दैट येलो कलर पीपीटी इंडिकेट कि दिस विल बी गिव अस द आयडोफॉर्म टेस्ट. इन मिथाइल अल्कोहल दिस ग्रुप इज एब्सेंट सो दिस विल बी नॉट गिव दिस आयडोफॉर्म टेस्ट दैट मीन इट विल नॉट गिव द येलो पीपीटी व्हेन रिएक्टेड विद द मिक्सचर ऑफ आयोडीन एंड सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड. Now I will be discuss the one more example with you. Like suppose I have propanol 2, propanol 2 and propanol 1. I have propanol 2 and propanol 1. It's again very simple. I'm discuss about propanol 2 and propanol 1. Now, simply we will draw their structure. Propanol 2, this is CH3 single bond C, single bond OH, single bond CH3, this is H. This is a propanol 2 and propanol 1, this is CH3, CH2, CH2, OH. Here you can see in propanol 2, this group is present, CH3, CH, OH group is present. That meaning this will be give us the positive iodoform test. Positive iodoform test. This meaning it will be reacted with the mixture of sodium hydroxide and iodine. Then it will give us the yellow PPT of iodoform. Whereas in this propanol 1, that group is absent. So this will be not give the iodoform test. That will give the negative iodoform test. Iodoform test. That meaning this will be not form the yellow color PPT when reacted with the mixture of sodium hydroxide and iodine. So this is very simple test to identify the in between the alcohol. Now again one more test I will be discuss with you, that is the butanol 2 and butanol 1. Butanol 2 and butanol 1. Butanol 2, this is butanol 2 and butanol 1. If I will be discuss the butanol 2 and butanol 1, so simply I will draw their structure. Butanol 2 meaning this is CH3, single bond CH, single bond OH, single bond CH2, single bond CH3. This is a butanol 2. And butanol 1 is CH3, CH2, CH2, CH2OH. Again very simple, this CH3CHOH group is present in butanol 2, so this will be give us the positive iodoform test, positive iodoform test. Whereas in butanol 1, that group is absent, so this will be not give iodoform test, not give iodoform test. So very simply we can identify which alcohol will give us the iodoform test and which one will not. Now after this I will be discuss the other method, that is very simple. You have read out, that was reduction with copper metal at 573 Kelvin. Already that we have discussed with you in the chemical properties. Now I will be discuss the chemical test between phenol and alcohol. Chemical test between phenol and alcohol. Chemical test that is between phenol and alcohol. That means any alcohol and phenol. Test between phenol and alcohol. So any alcohol we can take or phenol we can take. I'm discussing some test. So here I'm writing the name of the test. On that side I'm writing the phenol. And here I'm writing the alcohol. So very simply, if I will be discuss a chemical test, I'm going to discuss, I'm not discuss the all the test, some test I'm discussing here, like first is with ferric chloride solution. First test is with ferric chloride, that is FeCl3 solution. That is very important test, because when phenol reacted with ferric chloride solution, then it will be give us the violet complex, whereas alcohol will not give this violet complex. That means alcohol do not have any effect. Yeah, alcohol do not give this color with the FeCl3, not give any color. That means not give this color with this. Now the reaction, if I will discuss of phenol and FeCl3, suppose I'm taking here three molecules of phenol, C6H5OH, and FeCl3 is this FeCl3. They are react to each other, then the 3Cl atom reacted with 3H, release out 3HCl, and the other part is there C6H5O whole thrice Fe. This is the violet complex. Violet complex. So we can say that phenol will react with FeCl3 to give us a violet complex, whereas alcohol will not give this test. After this, the second test I'm discussing, that is a bromine water test. Bromine water test. Second test is bromine water test. This is Br2 water test. In chemical property of phenol, already we discussed this test. When phenol reacted with bromine water, I'm talking about the bromine water. This is 3Br2. This is a bromine water. Then it will be giving us the white PPT. White PPT of this is 2,4,6 tribromophenol. 2,4,6 tribromophenol. This is of white PPT. White PPT. Whereas alcohol will not give. Alcohol will not give. So this is the second identification of this. Third, I will be discuss about this is a coupling reaction. Coupling reaction. Already I have discussed with you in my previous video about the coupling reaction. Third test I will be discuss. This is the coupling. Coupling reaction. Coupling reaction we need read out already. We have discussed this. Phenol reacted with benzene diazonium chloride to give us a colored dye. To give us a colored dye. That meaning it give us the colored dye. When reacted with benzene diazonium chloride, like this is the benzene diazonium chloride. This is N double bond NCl. Reacted with phenol. This is the phenol. I can take the hydrogen which are present here outside. This is this Cl and H react to each other, release out HCl, and they are giving us the azo compound. This is N double bond N. This is the azo compound. That is a dye. Azo compound, which is orange in color. Orange in color. Its name is para-hydroxy-azobenzene. Para-hydroxy-azobenzene. Whereas alcohol will not give any azo compound when reacted with benzene diazonium chloride. So these are the very important tests that I will discuss with you. Some more tests are available here. But these are very important tests. That is why I have discussed with you. You can discuss about the litmus test also. Ki phenol turn blue litmus red. Because that is acidic in nature. Same. Alcohol do not have any effect on litmus solution. So these are some difference between phenol and alcohol. Now I hope you have understand these chemical tests in exam. Lots of time they are asking in sometime in 1 mark, sometime in 2 marks, ki how to distinguish between the pair of the given compound. So these tests you can follow if that will be related to alcohol or phenol. I hope you have understand now. In my next video, I will be discuss about the ether. Thank you.